So Cohere has released a very interesting new model, the Command R model. So this model is different than some of the models out there. They're not promoting it in the same way that other people like Mixtral, Anthropic, etc. have been promoting their models. So this model is aimed at retrieval augmented generation pipelines and also for doing large scale workloads. They're not making claims that this is the best generation model out there. It's not aimed at being necessarily the best at sort of logic or generation or things like that. It's actually aimed at using for RAG use, that's retrieval augmented generation, and also for tool use, so in the form of sort of function calling here. It's also a reasonably long context window with 128K tokens. And also the pricing of this is sort of all geared around making something that's on par with the GPT 3.5 Turbo model from OpenAI, which if you remember, that's got a context window of only 16K tokens. So this is definitely an interesting model. On top of that, they're also basically claiming strong capabilities for 10 languages. And the thing that I find most interesting about this is that while this is not an open source model, they've actually made the model weights available for people to do research and evaluation and for trying things out. Now, that means people can actually download the weights, they can try out different things themselves, and then they can decide whether they actually want to either pay for the API, which is how Cohere is suggesting people use this, and they're also saying that it will be in all the major cloud providers. Or if you want to run this on-prem, you'll be able to contact them and get a license for you to use the research and evaluation version. So this is kind of a new take on all of this, where suddenly this is not an open source model, but you're able then to access the weights, you're able to play around with it, you're able to perhaps do some fine tunings with it, see how good it is for your particular use context without having to pay for tokens. Of course, you're going to need to pay for serving it yourself or finding a way to serve this yourself. But it really is an interesting idea of that suddenly now this is sort of opened up. And I guess it's going to be on a sort of trust system as to whether people use this and then decide, yep, okay, this is what we want, and then go back to the API or perhaps do a fine tune of it or Laura fine tune of it or something. It will be interesting to see if Cohere allows you to upload fine tunes that you've done on this model and then they serve them or something like that going forward. So one of the things that Cohere is really focused on a lot is building, I guess, sort of models around the whole retrieval augmented generation process. So that has included building a very nice set of embedding models, but also then models for doing re-ranking of results that come back from a retrieval augmented generation. And they've proved to be definitely one of the sort of top creators of models like that. And we certainly haven't seen other LLM providers release models like that for these very specific tasks. So it does seem that Cohere is kind of positioning themselves for being a provider of everything that you need for retrieval augmented generation, with the exception maybe of the actual vector stores and the database side of things. So rather than release the normal benchmarks, they've gone for releasing a sort of some comparisons with other models. So here they're doing a comparison of themselves or of the Command R versus the Mixtral, Mixture of Experts model. So that's not Mistral's largest model. That's not the Mistral Large. This is the Mixtral model, which is basically an open source model that's out there. They're showing that this current model is able to retrieve and find things and perform better than Mixtral at that. They don't obviously compare to GPT-4. They don't compare to Gemini. They don't seem to be comparing to top tier models out there. So one of the things that they have done here is they've shown the whole needles in a haystack evaluation, and they're basically claiming that they're pretty close to perfect, I think, at being able to find the needles across the 128,000 contexts. It does seem people have gotten a lot better at getting their models to be able to find this, or that particular test needs to be sort of updated with some new versions to make it harder and hiding different things in different places, that kind of thing. So one of the other things that they mention about this model is that it's multilingual. And for them, that means that they're saying that it's got strong performance at 10 major languages in here. So most of these Western European languages, although we do have Arabic in there, which is something I know a lot of people have been looking for, Japanese, Korean, and Chinese are also some interesting choices there that haven't been supported by Mistral or by a lot of the other open source models. The last sort of key feature about this model, which is interesting, is the whole thing of tool use and sort of function calling. So they've trained this to be able to do tool use. And so here they're basically comparing that Command R does better than Llama 270 billion, does better than Mixtral, and does better than GPT 3.5 at tool use and at sort of multi-step reasoning with these kind of tools. So that one, I'm definitely a little bit suspicious. I want to see how you use it. And I think that's something that we can have a look at in the code in the future and see actually how well it does in here. So along with the new model, Cohere has also opened up some ways to actually test this. So if you come in and try this Coral UI, this basically lets you try out a whole bunch of things with the model quite nicely. So you can see that we could just chat to the model. So we're just doing a generative chat there, but we can also then do Coral with web search or Coral with documents. And so this is where you're sort of getting the retrieval augmented generation components kicking in that you're getting grounding. So the grounding can be either web search, which we can turn on or off, or we can upload some files. So what I thought is we'll have a little play with this and see for web search, how does it go for some of these? Okay, so I've asked it, tell me about the new open weights models Google has released, put in recently, called Gemma. So what it's going to do is basically do a web search first, find some stuff. And if we look at it, we will be able to see actually what it's found. So we can see that it's found the Google different blogs for this. Now, you'll notice that when we come in here, if we sort of click on one of these, we can actually see the citations. So if we want to see where it actually got a new family of lightweight models, we can see, okay, the family of lightweight models is coming from these docs and been referred to multiple times. So if we want to see about Gemma 7b, we can see that it's also got something from Hugging Face about that there. So this is where it's giving us an answer for this, and it's giving us the groundings of this. So we can see the actual web pages, but we can also see of the web pages, there are actually 9 of them in total. So we've got, looks like 4 Google ones, The Verge. What if I ask it, what does Verge say? Okay, so now we've got according to The Verge, and we can see now it's basically pulled back 3-4 references, it looks like, 3 of which relate to The Verge directly. And we can see that if we click into some of these, we can actually see it doesn't seem to always work. It seems a little bit buggy at the moment, but it's pretty cool that we can actually come through and see citations for this. As well as that, it will then suggest 1 or 2 other follow-up questions that you can do. So this is a very nice way to try out the RAG features of this model, is doing the web search sort of version of this. Okay, so now you can see that I'm using the grounding for the Coral with document. And I basically just uploaded the Gemma report paper here. Just check that I don't have internet on. Okay, so all the answers that we're getting now should be coming straight from that report. So when I ask it something like, does Gemma use RLHF? Yes, Gemma uses reinforcement learning from human feedback in its fine-tuning process. So let's see. If we click that, we can see, sure enough, it basically comes up as a citation to where it's mentioned actually in the paper in here. So let's ask it some things that it probably won't know. How many examples did Frank? Okay, the model's retained at a total of 8 trillion tokens. Okay, so that's a little bit misleading, right? That it's basically saying 8 trillion tokens. So 2 trillion for the 2 billion model and 6 trillion for the 7 billion model. That's not exactly a great answer there, but certainly also hasn't gotten the idea of how many did they train on for fine tune, I guess I should have said. Okay, the Gemma models were fine tuning mix of text only, English, synthetic, and human generated prompt response pairs. So if we click on that, sure enough, it will take us into something. Now, this still seems to be a little bit buggy at the moment, that it often works really well for the citations on the first question, but then after that, it seems to, they are actually in there, but it seems to be not doing a great job of actually showing that in here. So I think the best thing is come in here and have a try of this yourself. It's certainly interesting to see that they've put this up and you can actually try it out and stuff like that. If you want to actually use the model yourself, you can do this. So this is basically up here in Hugging Face. It's a 35 billion parameter model with a context length of 128K. So to basically load this up and use it, you're going to need a decent amount of GPUs, or you're going to need to basically do the whole sort of 4-bit thing. Even then, I think you may still need an A100 to actually run this. So if you want to try out the tool use stuff yourself, here they've got some code examples of how you can do this. So it's a little bit similar to OpenAI in that you're going to basically pass in a sort of JSON schema of what it is that you want and then what you expect to get back. So it's going to be interesting to see how does LangChain support this, and things like the instructor library use this. So I may make a follow-up video about that once I had a little bit of a play around with the tool use myself in here. Overall, though, I would say this is definitely a very encouraging release from Cohere. While they were one of the first ones to come out and raise a lot of money to be a competitor against OpenAI along with Anthropic, their models have generally been not awesome for sort of generation, the large language models that they've released. So it is really nice to see them basically release this model, which seems to be a very good workhorse model for a variety of different use cases and is perhaps better for multilingual use as well for this. As always, if you've got any comments or questions, put them in the comments below. I'll try to respond at least for the first day or so that the video is up. If you found the video useful, please click and subscribe, and I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.